do not sleep.
Ice hockey games are loud. Very loud! Two weeks ago on UK Ice Hockey, that amazing Belfast crowd screamed and shouted their team to a 2-1 victory over the Sheffield Steelers. But tonight, for the second leg of their Challenge Cup semi-final, the team are back at the Steelers' Den. And several thousand Yorkshiremen and women may have something to say about the outcome.
They come in, they're the visitors. You know, all we need is one shot and we're back in that hockey game. So every fan in Sheffield should be there because that's going to be a classic encounter.
Hold on to your hats. It's about to get very noisy indeed. Welcome to UK Ice Hockey on 4Later. I'm Henry Naylor. Now, you join us at the semi-final of the Challenge Cup, a fantastic fixture in prospect between the Sheffield Steelers and the Belfast Giants. We've also been joined tonight by the coach of the London Knights and also the British national squad, Chris McSorley, who'll be giving us his comments. But first of all, we're going to show you how the teams got to the semi-finals. Sheffield may have dominated the Secunda Super League this year, but they've struggled in the Challenge Cup. A narrow victory in London in our first match here on UK Ice Hockey kept them in the competition. Just a week on from there, it was do or die again. They had to beat Belfast or face elimination from the semi-final draw. But the Steelers did just that, and it meant that they were matched up against Belfast once again in the semis. Belfast took the first leg by 2-1, which leaves tonight's match perfectly poised.
Well then, time to look forward to this evening's game with your UK ice hockey team. We've got an extra member this evening. It's coach of the London Knights and the Great Britain team, Chris McSorley. Chris, can I get you to put yourself in the heads of the two coaches this evening? If you're Dave Whistler, if you're Mike Blaisdell, what are you telling your guys?
Well, definitely here with Mike Blaisdell, starting here with the home coach. This guy's got to come out and play go-get-em hockey. If you allow Belfast to get their legs under him and get used to the crowd and get acclimated, you're going to see Belfast get stronger as the game goes on. So you're going to see a lot of heavy forechecking immediately. On the other hand, Coach Whistle, he knows how to play on the road. This team's been on the road for 2 months at the start of the season. This team's resilient to the road. Watch for Coach Whistle to come out with his team, try it again to gain the offensive zone. Hooker by crook, they're going to dump the puck, go after him, and try to create a little chaos in the Sheffield zone.
Seth Bennett, you've been looking at the team news. What is it? What's it going to mean?
Well, the big news this evening is the fact that Scott Allison's going to come back for the Sheffield Steelers lineup. He's going to be a huge key for them. He's a big, strong, physical leader, really. That's one of the most important facets he's got. He's going to get in the corners. He's really going to muck and grind. As for the Belfast Giants, they've got Jerry Keefe. He's going to be missing. He's added some goal-scoring punch the last few times they've played against Sheffield. He'll be one of the key players, but perhaps a little less so than Allison.
As we can hear, a great atmosphere. How much difference is that going to make this evening?
Well, the top scorer right now for the Sheffield Steelers is Dave Sims, their public announcer. This guy, over 30 home games, he's good for one goal every game. Watch him get the crowd behind him, and Dave Sims get his goal for the night.
Well, then, as you can hear, it's really building up to quite a fixture here at the Sheffield Arena. Make sure you stick with us. What's going to be a great game. Final second leg at the Sheffield Arena. Scott Allison for the Sheffield Steelers, only out there because he's appealing against a lengthy ban for a nasty incident against Nottingham the other week. Already voices have been raised suggesting he shouldn't be in this starting lineup.
He joins Warren Norris and Paul Adey up front with Adam Smith and Jeff Sebastian, perhaps the best 1-2 punch on defence in the Super League. Another thing to look out with the Sheffield Steelers, they've decided to go with Mike O'Neill between the pipes as opposed to Mike Torcher in the first leg.
Well, let's turn to the Belfast lineup then. They're missing Jerry Keefe, who scored the winner, of course, in that 2-1 first leg game.
Corey Carlander centres the first line with Paul Ferrone and Paxton Schulte alongside him. Carlander actually started the season as one of the top point scorers in the league. He's tailed off a little bit though, taking some criticism from the fans, but that's as he's tightened up his own defensive game.
The Air Scottish Eagles are already in the Challenge Cup final. Those fans want to see the Belfast Giants join them. It's at the Odyssey in Belfast, which could make a huge difference for them. Here we go then, just about to get the match underway. Absolutely crucial, and Scott Allison will take the opening shift. We'll see how he can perform this evening under all that pressure. Belfast win the opening face-off, put it round behind Mike O'Neill's net. He flips it out there, Adey going in and Smith laying on the hit early on. Comes out towards the left-hand side. Sheffield making their way down this wing. Can't see the puck against the boards near side. Stewart picks it up for Belfast and touches up for the icing.
Well, it looks like Belfast have set a stall out to come out physical just behind the play. Here's big Jason Bowen, who went right in on tight on Scott Allison, and Allison just avoided that check, but I'm sure if Bowen would have made any contact, he would have definitely taken a penalty.
Face-off then, inside Sheffield territory, as Belfast Giants look to get what would be a crucial early goal. Scott Allison winning that face-off. Smith trying to put it round behind and can. Adey then, playing it out through his own zone, taking the check for his pains. Belfast pick it up, trying to keep the early pressure going. That's good defensive work from Sheffield. And they may have a bit of a breakout on here. This is Sebastian with the puck. He's got Adey inside him. Wires the shot on net instead. Rebounds loose. Norris is in there, still loose. Here comes Allison! Oh, Allison! Fairy tale for Scott Allison and the Sheffield Steelers. Nightmare for the Belfast Giants. It's level after just 46 seconds.
Giants with all the early pressure, but there's Jeff Sebastian, the defenseman, on the breakout. Fires it in high, the rebound comes out, Wilkinson makes a save, but there's the man, Scott Allison. All eyes are looking at him, and his eyes are looking at the back of the net as he puts the Steelers into the lead.
But Seth, it's the initial shot from Sebastian that creates all the chaos, isn't it?
Yeah, the shot was always rising, and it just came up into the armpit, and there's Scott Allison using his reach just to get there ahead of Wilkinson.
So, two apiece on aggregate, 1-0 to the Steelers in front of their hometown fans this evening, and all on the first shift as well. Backwards they go now, playing it around in defence. That will give them some real momentum, some real sense of destiny. McCosh wires one through on net, tried to get it in there, but the hack from Wright comes after he blocked that shot down. Rick Brabant in the corner, out to Longstaff on the hash mark. Longstaff wires it in, and really Wilkinson being made to work terribly hard here at the moment.
Yeah, Belfast had the early play in the first couple of shifts, but now the Steelers have come back into it a little bit, and they look like they're just trying to put any kind of rubber they can on Wilkinson.
So a dream start for Sheffield and for Scott Allison, rubbing out the Giants' advantage after less than a minute of play. The Steelers should have taken the lead moments later through Paul Adey, following a pinpoint assist from Dale Craigwell. We rejoin the match still early on in the first period.
So, final few seconds of this power play for the Sheffield Steelers. They set it up straight away, get it straight in. Again, the rebound comes out. There's a little hook laid on just to put the man to the ice before he can get to the puck. Back it goes towards the blue line, out into neutral territory, and back to full strength go the Belfast Giants. Simpson out towards Norris on his right-hand side. Norris backhands it around the boards. Metcalf fires it out in front, no one in the slot, and Belfast bring it out through neutralised. A little bit of a misfire there, should allow the Steelers to tidy up. Around the back from Smith. We'll look for it behind, and Belfast being aggressive on the forecheck, but they can't hold it in. Johnson lets it skip over his stick into neutral ice. Forward on the backhand now. And Belfast just playing things around, trying to settle it down, trying to get calm after the early blow of that Scott Allison goal. Knocking it forward, looking for opportunities now. Ferrone's in there looking for the pass inside. It's never going to reach him. Intercepted by Sheffield. Come away left-hand side. Metcalf try and flip it in and dumps it in to the zone for the line change.
Sheffield Steelers, as you just see them skating off on a line change here, they're trying to use some short, energetic shifts to try and get right under the skin of the Belfast Giants early on. But you have to say the Giants have come back into it well after conceding that early goal.
Roberts, former Sheffield Steeler, trying to get things going down at left-hand side. He's there to pounce on that mistake, drives it in. They're asking where the offside was, I think, as O'Neill falls on it.
Well, I have to say, I'm a little bit surprised it wasn't an offside call, but Steve Roberts was doing his job. He came in, he's got such a great shot as he snaps this one in. But Mike O'Neill, known as the vacuum, didn't let any rebounds out there.
There isn't a better pair of goaltenders in the country than Sheffield's Mike Torcher and Mike O'Neill, first and fourth in the Super League standings. And both have saved well over 90% of all shots on goal.
Certainly been a lively start to this game, living up to its billing so far in front of this big crowd at the Sheffield Arena. Sheffield inside Belfast territory now, going ahead through on goal. Wilkinson tries to close the door, it's near post, fired in from the far post, and only just knocks that down in front. Good work by Adey setting up that opportunity. Belfast clear it now, and it'll be driven in by Roberts.
Steelers with a great chance. That was all about Ken Simpson's speed. He was buzzing around the back of the net, but Wilkinson is starting to get a little bit of confidence, making a couple of early saves.
Driven out towards this left-hand side then. Sheffield being made to work as Simpson has to ride the hit, and then Smith as well. Back it goes. Sebastian flipping it through and out. They were trying to get away there. Rick Brabant takes a bit of a swan dive in centre ice. He'll do that from time to time. I think it might just draw the penalty as well.
Rick Brabant, very, very experienced, and he had a lot of speed there. Just skating through centre ice. He looked up, he was going for the puck, and Wright really had no choice but to bring him down. Otherwise, he would have been home free.
Great penalty drawer, Rick Brabant. Sometimes his reputation precedes him, and it means he doesn't get penalties he might deserve. But it's going to mean another Sheffield Steelers power play.
And that's a power play that's not been as good as you would expect this year, because Sheffield have been so dominant in the league, yet the power play has been nowhere near the top end.
Beraldo on the hash marks, feeding it back towards the blue line. Sheffield just probe and push for the opening. He's there again, flips it in behind net. That was good defensive work for a moment. Come out near side, back it goes. Towards Beraldo, drives it in, wires it through, and just wide of the net. It'll go right round the boards, and Belfast will get the chance to reset as Sheffield come at them again.
Well, we've already talked about the Sheffield Steelers' power play and how it works. They're always trying to feed poor Beraldo on that left-hand side so he can one-time the puck at the net. And he tried then, he just couldn't get it on target.
Here they go again, setting it up in the zone, the Sheffield Steelers. That takes a funny bounce off the boards there, and Weaver has to go in after it. So does Longstaff. Gets it out towards Weaver, who tries the shot, drawn net. Longstaff's there as well, bounces off Wilkinson, and Carlander just manages to get it clear. O'Neill tries to get things going swiftly again, coming out of his net. Rick Brabant back to McCosh, and Belfast still aggressive, still trying to keep Sheffield pinned back on this power play, which is with Craigwell now. Craigwell looks to put it round behind the net, gets it right around to Rick Brabant, who has options all over the ice. He's got it to Weaver. Weaver behind the net, being held against the boards, pops out for Beraldo. Beraldo skating around. He's on the blue line now. Three of them stacked up there for the Sheffield Steelers, and none of them can keep it in.
Giants doing a great job on the penalty kill. They're just forcing the Steelers and pushing them as hard as they can, and that's why the puck ended up coming out of the zone.
Interception by Searle. Perhaps not the man you'd want it to come to. He was looking for the return there. Didn't get it. Intercepted. Taken away, and here's Allison down the left-hand side for the Steelers. Allison feeds it inside. Surely it must be. It is for the Sheffield Steelers. Paul Adey pounces on Allison's feed from the left, and on the power play as it broke down for Belfast, the Steelers go ahead.
Scott Allison racing down the boards. He's looking up though, heads up hockey. As he drew the man across, he looked inside, and there was Paul Adey. And Paul Adey, such a sniper, he's not going to miss from that kind of distance. But there you see, Allison just feed it inside, tape to tape. Oh, TC right in the top corner.
Allison has been on fire and really leading this team. Well, the crowd are so into this now after those two opening goals. And Seth, it's completely changed the complexion of the game.
Well, it has. Sheffield have taken the lead on aggregate in this game. Now it's 3-2 on aggregate to the Steelers, and they're going to just be brimming with confidence.
And here they come again with Carpenter pushing inside. Fired shot. Wilkinson gives up the rebound. Simpson's there to pounce on it. Pushes it out towards the blue line. Flip through on net again. No one can quite get a hold of it for Sheffield. And Belfast can relieve the pressure, at least just for a few moments, as Rod Stevens exchanges passes there. Taken away and kept in by Colin Ward, trying to bounce it off the boards. But once again, Sheffield Steelers, who seem almost have one or two men more out on the ice at times at the moment than the Belfast Giants, they're playing so, so well already in this game. They are really up for it, and Scott Allison is leading the charge.
Well, with the Giants being so much under the cosh in this first few minutes, really, what they need to do is they need to just get a hold of the puck and just start dumping it into the Steelers' zone.
And here comes Metcalf trying to fight his way through, and that was just stripped away from him in the last minute by Jason Bowen. And once again, Sheffield nearly through.
Yeah, the Belfast defence just keeps opening up and allowing the Steelers forwards to drive right in on net. If you think of the last goal, Paul Adey was all alone and Alisson was all alone for the first goal. So what they're going to have to do is they're really going to have to tighten up.
O'Neill at the other end called into action. Metcalf, though, can get it clear for the Sheffield Steelers. Nearly another breakaway again. I don't think Longstaff is going to have the beating of Owen here. He does win it against the Boers, though. Manages to feed it out in front, but Belfast tie their men up. Carlander gets it clear. Weaver feeds it through on net. Stopped by Wilkinson, and they'll just calm it down for the moment, but always under pressure, Belfast, never allowed to settle by the Sheffield Steelers, who just seem to have an extra gear or two. Here's Paul Ferrone now, he flips it through on net, long, long rebound from Mike O'Neill, sends it well away from net, and Rick Brabant can hold it in the neutral zone. And still, Sheffield Steelers coming at the Belfast Giants here. Sebastian now, down this left-hand side, just stripped away from him. Assist on the first goal. Sebastian went forward looking for another one here. And everyone is involved in this Sheffield Steelers forward play at times. Here they go in the corners now, trying to dig it out there of the Sheffield Steelers. Paul Beraldo waiting for it, picks it up against the boards. He's got Weaver as an option to one side. If he can get it out and dig it out of that corner, he's held in there. Now he brings it out towards his right. Gets it through on net. Smith tried to take the shot. Bounces all over the place. No one's quite got hold of it. Fired out in front again. Smith will fire it in. Oh, just goes wide and around the boards. And what a sequence of play for the Sheffield Steelers.
Adam Smith will be bitterly disappointed. Two chances. He tried to just bustle his way all the way through to the net. First time round, he couldn't make the finish. And then he had a half-empty net. He fired it, but he just went over the top.
Extraordinary stuff from the Sheffield Steelers. And listen to this crowd. They're enjoying this a lot here at the Sheffield Arena. It's been a while, I think, since they've seen hockey quite like this. Norris drops it off now. Driven shot once again, fielded by Wilkinson, who's really having just to knock everything away from in front of him at the moment, and he's not really getting hold of anything.
No, he's really fighting the puck, is Wilkinson. He needs to just get a hold of it and perhaps freeze the puck a few times and get a few face-offs and just try and calm the game down.
But the game is flying, and Belfast at the other end now trying to create something as McCosh tries to hold it in. They're fighting it out of that corner. That is excellent, excellent work from Stevens. Stevens feed it through on net, and O'Neill kicks it down to his right and puts his glove on it.
Well, we're going to get a penalty on the play. Paul Adey for the Sheffield Steelers was just caught holding, and the referee just stuck his right arm in the air. I think we're going to get a chance to see this. Paul Adey just at the bottom of the screen. It looked like he was in a headlock there, but he's the man that's going to skate to the box.
And Paul Adey goes to sit for 2 minutes. Doesn't take a whole load of penalty minutes. Gets them for doing his job there.
Here's that chance to see Adam Smith. He fires this one, banks it right off the outside of the net. Then the puck breaks out in front. Jason Weaver has a go. The puck breaks out again. It comes off that right-hand post as we look at it. And then it fires in again. Adam Smith just over the top.
So it's a penalty on Sheffield. Chris, what happened there?
Well, this is a crucial opportunity now for Belfast, but there's some holding down low. Belfast knows they've got to go after Sheffield now with two men. They almost have to pull the plug now, and they have to go after it. All stops pulled. But I don't know what Mike Blaisdell has fed this team here, but he's better package it and sell it, because this team is playing out of its skin right now. It's going to be very, very difficult to overcome at this point.
Despite the one-man advantage, Belfast just couldn't break down the Steelers' defence. First Kevin Riel, and then Todd Goodwin denied here by O'Neill in the Steelers' goal. So everything's still going Sheffield's way. We rejoin the action with Brabant and Johnson having taken a trip to the sin bin for this little meeting of minds. Sheffield leading on aggregate, thanks to those two goals by Alisson and Adey. Very feisty.
We're 4-on-4 then. It's in Belfast territory. Seems to be spending a lot of time there, the puck. Sheffield trying to wire it through on net again. They're still making Wilkinson work, even from distance. Around the back it goes. Too many bodies in front to look for the opportunity. Here's McCosh now. McCosh looking for the backhand. Goes past, wide, around the boards. Belfast, big hit laid on there to try and hold it in the zone by Smith. But he's forced backwards in the end. And Sheffield just regroup.
4-on-4 hockey, slightly different. So much more room out there, and the defensemen really have to jump up into the play and get involved.
This is Simpson, all that speed down the right-hand side. Simpson pulls a nice little move. Will take it round the net. He does have Weaver waiting out in front, if he can find him. Brings it all the way round the back, looking for the blue line. There's going to be a whistle. I think it's going to bring up a penalty. It must be against the Steelers.
Yeah, I think what you saw here was Shane McCosh just made a little play, and it was actually off the puck, because Simpson brought the puck all the way around the zone. You see McCosh come in, he just takes his man out. That's called a pick, and that means that Simpson has all that extra room to play in, but unfortunately it's illegal, so McCosh has got to take 2 minutes.
looked almost like just man-on-man all over the ice. And watch for Belfast right now to try to, again, once again, to get the puck to the net. They're going to try some rebounding here on O'Neill. What you have here is a very unique situation. It's a 4-on-3 contest. As coaches, throw tactics out the window. This is just a battle of wills right now.
Only one goal between these teams on aggregate. Belfast will never have a better chance to do something about that than they do now. They put the hit on Adam Smith. Bouncing out in front. This is Carlander. So many points on the season. Feet it out towards the left-hand side. And then we'll look for the return on the blue line. Gets it. Takes it to the top of the circle. And then just pushes it down low. Nice passing from Belfast. Driven in now. O'Neill gives up the rebound but gets the second shot.
Oh, fantastic passing by the Belfast Giants. And beautiful one-touch passing as well. And Mike O'Neill forced to make the save. But here you see the distribution. It comes across. A little fake shot. Goes down low. He gets the pass quickly back. His nice pass all the way across to Rob Stewart. And Stewart absolutely winds this one up. Fires it in. Mike O'Neill, little rebound. But there he is. He keeps it so close to him. He's just able to jump on it quickly. Adam Smith also doing a good job.
Belfast not able to turn that power play into goals. They finish the period 2-0 down. And crucially, one goal behind on aggregate.
So 2-0, Chris, is that a fair score after the first period?
Well, I think you can say David Sims, the announcer here at Sheffield, and this crowd are up 2-0. This team came out with a lot of momentum backed by their fans and their public announcer. But I think I saw Belfast start to dominate the last half that period. So watch to see what's going to happen. I'm sure there's going to be some powwows going on underneath. And watch Belfast come out a much better club.
Chris, thank you very much. Join us after the break. Welcome back to UK Ice Hockey on 4 later. The score so far, Sheffield Steelers 2, the Belfast Giants 0. If the score stays the same, then Sheffield make the final. Chris, you've been down in the locker room. What's the feelings down there?
Well, definitely there's a very, very concerned coach whistle with the Belfast Giants. He came out of the locker room. I think he's really pressing his players to play their roles. He wants the bangers to bang, and he wants the scorers to score. And when that room emptied, you saw these guys hit the ice very, very, very focused. On the other hand, Sheffield, that team's been a lot of loosey-goose. I think you're seeing those players going to sit back in the group and try to relax in the score. And if they relax too much, watch for Belfast jump back in this game.
Well, if they can start a comeback, there are enough Belfast fans in the crowd to provide vocal support, including this good-looking group.
Oh, we got now the balmy army of the Giants here. How many games? Can I ask you, how many games do you see a season?
All of them.
Home and away?
I'm a season ticket holder.
In Belfast?
Yeah.
You're a bit of a traitor. You've got a Yorkshire accent. What are you supporting? Yeah!
Men in Belfast. From Belfast.
How come you're supporting Belfast?
I live over there.
But obviously you're backing your guys to get there, are you, tonight?
Yes. If they want to get there, there's no doubt about it.
If they don't get there, we won't be disappointed. They've done us proud.
And what do you expect for next season? You think you can do even better?
Yes, definitely. We're going to win everything.
What a great bunch of fans they are. They've really brought some colour to this league in Belfast's first season.
And it's so impressive. There's such a good number of them over here in Sheffield this evening, and they've really offered a lot of support. What a fantastic game of hockey this has been so far.
Absolutely. Great game. Not going Belfast's way. It's 2-0 on the night, but that means only one goal on aggregate.
Belfast have had their chances, though. I don't think you can deny that.
Here they are now on the puck, Belfast, going from right to left. They're in those teal, carefully chosen teal shirts. Out towards that left-hand side it goes for the Sheffield Steelers, but they can't make it stick. Paul Ferrone has it back inside his own zone. Down the right-hand wing, takes a kick off a linesman there. Sheffield pick it up.
I think one thing that Belfast are going to have to do is they're going to have to come out very, very hard in the start of the period. And we're just already seeing an early hit from Carlander, but they're going to have to do more of that to get back into this game.
Norris claiming the hook there as he skated into the zone. That won't be given by referee Mike Rowe, and away will come Belfast with Ferrone dropping it off. This line's not expected to produce a great deal offensively, and there they've given up the offside.
I think the thing that Belfast have to really remain focused on is the fact that on aggregate they're still only one goal behind, and that's not a whole lot. There's still a lot of hockey game to go, and I think they've just got to keep that right at the front there, and if they do get one goal, it's all tied up again.
The next goal could be pretty important to this match, because at the moment Sheffield do have Belfast somewhat on the back foot. Longstaff pushes it in towards that right-hand corner. Whistle goes, and I think it's going to be a penalty.
Well, referee Mike Rose just making the signal there that it's going to be Colin Ward who's going to be skating across to the penalty box. Mike Rose just raising his arms across his chest. That means interference.
So Colin Ward out for 2 minutes, 5-on-4 for 2 minutes for the Sheffield Steelers. And so early in the period, these moments can be crucial to games. One, the opening face-off by the Belfast Giants. Weaver gloving it down in neutral ice and sending it back so they can just set the play up from their own zone, the Sheffield Steelers, and get it going the way they want to and get some speed through neutral ice. Under pressure, and they get it away now. Weaver has it across centre ice, out towards Longstaff. Longstaff. Geordie bounces off the back of the net. That was a good bit of play using the boards there. Not able to get the shot off and onto the hash marks it goes. Longstaff trying to play it down on the backhand, stripped away from him, but Sheffield do well to keep it in the zone. And now Weaver's on the chase behind the net. Round the boards it goes. Just circling the puck, the Sheffield Steelers. Always looking for that key killer pass. Beraldo quarterbacking the play, putting it across towards Brabant. Brabant wires it through on net and just passed.
Well, that took a funny kick off the boards and went straight over the back into the black curtain at the back of this arena. And Wilkinson, not seen any rubber so far on the power play, but the Steelers finally set this up in the zone, got it across to Rick Brabant, and Brabant with a good shot here. It just goes right off the top of the catcher and over the plate.
Still power play Sheffield Steelers then. Rick Brabant against Todd Goodwin on the face-off, and won by the Sheffield Steelers. That could be vital. McCosh out towards that left-hand side. McCosh, such a high-scoring defenceman, puts it down low. Brabant's free. Brabant misfires and gets it in the back of the net anyway. He didn't catch that properly. He'll be the first to admit that, but it won't matter because it's found its way past Wilkinson, perhaps because it was a mishit. And suddenly the Steelers have a two-goal lead on aggregate.
Great heads-up hockey from Paul Barada. He feeds this one all the way out. Wilkinson completely screened by Searle. And there was Brabant. He went top corner, but the puck was wobbling all over the place. I think he wouldn't have been completely happy with the fact that he didn't get good wood on that.
Well, believe it or not, what they're saying is, whoosh, it's behind you. It tends to be directed at the opposition netminder here at the Sheffield Arena. It's been an exhibition of hockey from the Sheffield Steelers that is really lifting this crowd to the feet and really winding the atmosphere up, and it won't do anything for Belfast mood or confidence.
No, it's so loud in here at the moment. It's going to be like that extra player out there on the ice for the Sheffield Steelers, and they're going to have to use that to their advantage. Belfast's first thing is they have to shut the crowd up and just get back into this game.
Well, the challenge was laid down by the crowd in Belfast, who are superb. Here they come now with Roberts. Roberts fires that in. O'Neill not round him and into the back of the net, but the whistle's gone and it's been washed out by Mike Rowe. And Roberts, stick up maybe?
Yeah, oh, definitely. I think we're going to see on the replay here. Roberts comes in, he snaps a shot, it's deflected back out. He just raises his stick up here. Oh, great hand-eye coordination to pull it down from above head height. But if your stick's pretty much above your waist, it's not going to count as far as the referee's concerned.
So far, nothing going the Giants' way, but they were still only two goals behind an aggregate, and Sheffield's growing penalty count was keeping them in with a shout. With Allison and Smith off the ice for the Steelers, the Giants came close to pulling a goal back through Jason Wright. We rejoin the match with Belfast still on the power play, but still desperately needing to find a way past Sheffield netminder O'Neill.
So Belfast now camped out in the Sheffield zone, looking to make something of this power play. Schulte puts the big hit on, ridden by Carpenter, and puts it around the board. Sheffield desperately trying to clear their zone, but Belfast really going after them and really making a game of it. Out into neutral ice it goes now, though.
That's exactly what Belfast have to do, though. They have to be physical. They've got the likes of Ferrone and Schulte as Adam Smith comes out of the penalty box, but they've got to use them in a physical presence.
Carlander, the playmaker, down the left-hand side. Carlander trying to pull it in. Well marshalled out of that by Sebastian. And away come the Sheffield Steelers now, down this right-hand side. This is Weaver. Weaver circling round behind the net, maybe looking for the wraparound. Feeds it from Brabant instead, and it just goes wide, and I'm not sure how.
Great play by Jason Weaver. One-handed, he used one hand to hold off the defenceman, and the other hand to shoot a puck on goal. And Rick Brabant, great chance, but he couldn't quite finish.
It's Kelman, kicked away by O'Neill and then put away by Paul Beraldo, clearing up the rebound from in front of his own goaltender.
Oh, end-to-end hockey. We've got some... This is a great hockey game.
Away it comes now with Sheffield again and Weaver again, trying to find Beraldo just inside him. Belfast will bring it back. Roberts, a former Steeler himself, trying to play it forward on the ice. He knows pretty well he's got it back there, but he just showed a little bit too much of that. He gets it back on the bounce off Brabant's stick check. And away will come Sheffield now, putting it over the top. Pressure swinging either direction. As here we go now with Wright, bouncing it off those far boards and behind the net. And Sheffield touch up for a welcome for everybody. Icing.
Yeah, the Sheffield Steelers have played so well in this one. And the thing you've got to mention is the fact that the Belfast Giants have done really well, as we're going to see Jason Weaver again. He comes around, look, one-handed here. He tries to fire it on the backhand side, just lays it up. And what a defensive play by Carlander. We talked about that before the game. And he stole that right off Rick Raban's stick. If he wasn't there, that's guaranteed goal.
Well, hockey moves so quickly. Sometimes what can look at first sight like an offensive miss can actually be a great bit of defensive work. Fortunate to have that angle there to show us exactly the good work that Carlander did. That's Metcalf dropping it on the backhand for Norris. Norris trying to feed it through on net. No one waiting in the slot and collected comfortably by Searle. Out on that right-hand side now. Intercepted in centre ice. Adey now trying to flip it forward and get things going again for the Sheffield Steelers. Norris is going to chase into the corner and carry Ward there around the boards. Adey flips it in behind the net. That's good work from him. Metcalf's there to pick it up behind the net. Wrestle for it against the boards. Attention to Searle. Bounces out in front. Great opportunity. Driven in. And goodness only knows how that missed from Craigwell.
Absolutely beautiful feed out in front. And Dale Craigwell, he's more of a playmaker than a goal scorer, but he would have wanted to put this one away as it comes right to his tape. He looks up, he has one stride, and then bang, he tries to go top corner. And he carried on going, he went to the top of the arena.
Good work from Wilkinson, though. He came out and narrowed the angle. Craigwell didn't have a lot to look at, did he?
No, he's a relatively big goalie, and when he jumps out to the top of his crease, he really makes it tough for the goal scorers to see any net.
Good face-off win for the Belfast Giants, who are coming under the most pressure still in this game, but still getting their looks at the other end. Carlander into the corner he goes. He's being marshalled away, but still manages to get it back to the blue line. They wire it through, and O'Neill, I thought for a moment the net was empty because O'Neill had jumped out in the crowd of players to make sure he got hold of that puck.
Well, that's Mike O'Neill's style. He's a goaltender that plays the angles so well, and that's what we see here. Bowen with a good shot in from the point, but Mike O'Neill's above the top of the crease, and he just collapses on this.
Right here at Belfast is that they can't seem to find a chink in Sheffield's armor. Their defense is standing pretty tall. O'Neill, he's a guy that's really seeing everything. They're gonna have to get their butts in his face to get bodies around the crease. So whatever O'Neill cannot see, he's not gonna be able to stop. As it stands right now, Belfast right now, a better change momentum and get their physical play going. Belfast is one of the most physical teams in the league. And right now, if Bowen or Schulte or Perrone don't get going and start banging some bodies, I think that's been a big key on why this team has not really shown up here this evening.
But Bowen, Schulte and the rest just couldn't get close enough to get physical. This defence-splitting pass by Dale Craigwell to David Longstaff, typifying the Steelers' unstoppable form. Wilkinson again standing up to the best Sheffield could throw at him. Let's go back to Seth and Colin with a dejected Paxton Schulte in the bin on a tripping call.
And the power play this evening for the Sheffield Steelers has been so, so productive. They'll want to get it going again. Round the back it goes now. Longstaff's there to pick it up against the board. Digs it out nicely and flips that forward, looking to stretch Belfast, and they've done so. Here's Rick Raban feeding it back inside. Longstaff balls move to the post. Weaver, oh my, what a save! What a save! Great anticipation from Wilkinson.
Two things here. First of all is the nice pass from Raban. It comes inside, move here from Longstaff, inside out. Then the save, stacking them up. That was beautiful. Jason Weaver will be bitterly disappointed, but he just got robbed.
Well, something goes right for Belfast at last. Wilkinson, what a save that was. And really, you might have expected him to stay where he was and look for the shot from Longstaff. As Sheffield win the face-off, get it back towards the point. Sebastian exchanging passes, and then it's fed down low where Allison, who's been driving this team forward, is in the corner to dig it out. Sebastian wires it through on net. That takes a kick. No one there for it. Carpenter has it now. Carpenter looking for the bounce. It comes out clean. This is Sebastian again. Wires it through on net. Into the back of the net. Oh, what a shot that! Sebastian, he got it back on the point, raised his stick and lashed it.
Puck bubbling, Sebastian settles it down and then bingo, lets the bullet go from the point. Wilkinson was screened out in front, didn't see the puck till it was past him. Sheffield Steelers have just got that vice-like grip on this game now. Another chance to see it. There you see the screen out in front. It was Ken Simpson and Sebastian just fired it all the way through, right into the corner of the net.
Well, we saw earlier on in this series of UK ice hockey just how hard these players can hit the puck. 95 miles an hour, that can travel towards you. And what you don't see, you can't stop. Crowd's happy. Steelers 4-0 up on the night. Three goals on aggregate. Belfast not out of it on the scoreline, but they've got to get some momentum going, Seth.
They do. They have to just find some way to pin Sheffield back, because Sheffield right now are like a steam train. They just keep going and going and going.
They're rolling now. This is Simpson. Drops it off for 80. Whistle's gone. Referee signals a penalty. 2 minutes for roughing on Metcalf behind the play.
4-0, Chris.
But surely there's no way back now for Belfast.
Well, it's going to be a tough road, and I kind of feel kind of sorry here for Coach Whistle. You know, he's an excellent coach. Last year he won the ISL league title, but this team knows what to do. I played against Belfast. My team's played really well against them, but this is a great team that's done. Whistle's done a great job with them. But, you know, the game's only reached just past the halfway mark, and there's still a lot of hockey to play, but Sheffield's going to be a very, very tough opponent to come back against.
That's Scott Metcalf in the bin for the Steelers. Also a penalty on the Belfast Giants, Jason Bowen for roughing. So we're 4-on-4. Short picks it up off the face-off win for the Sheffield Steelers. Flips it in on the backhand. They're going to try and make Belfast work in their own zone, exploit the space. Riel going into the corner. Longstaff digs it out. That's Brabant. Great opportunity. Great goal. Great opportunist goal from the Sheffield Steelers as Longstaff pounced on it. Fed Brabant. He couldn't miss.
Great Brabant with the hard work in the corners. He gets it to Longstaff. Beautiful pass. Oh my, what a pass. And there was Rick Brabant. He had the easy job of just forcing that one home. But that pass from David Longstaff from behind the back of the net, how he managed to get the angle was amazing.
This Sheffield Steelers team is stunning at the moment. The beauty of this, the way Longstaff sent Wilkinson the wrong way. Wilkinson's expecting it to come round the back of the net and left all sorts of room at that near post for Rick Brabant.
I don't think it matters who's playing against the Sheffield Steelers tonight. Right now they're just on fire and it's going to take some stopping.
Here they go, they're heading towards a final moment. Belfast trying to come straight back at them though. That was a good opportunity. Another great save by O'Neill from Rob Stewart's shot.
Nice save to stack up the pads, just forcing Rob Stewart wide. Mike O'Neill not put a skate wrong this evening.
That was right off the face-off. It could have been so, so crucial.
Yeah, Rob Stewart, the defenceman, coming through. Two defencemen leading the rush. Fired in, rebound comes out, but Stewart couldn't do anything with it.
They're playing out of their skins, and I haven't seen a Sheffield squad like this all season. But if I'm Coach Whistle, yeah, you can try to salvage it. It is a winner-take-all, but I don't know if it's going to happen out here tonight.
Hey, what could he do?
Well, all you can do right now is, again, you know, just... that's a good question. I don't know.
Pray.
Sorry. I'm out of answers. You got me the first time ever speechless.
Chris out of words, Belfast out of luck. The Steelers dominating the match with Allison, Eddie Brabant and Sebastian all on the score sheet.
Let's see if the Giants can achieve a miracle and score four goals in the third period.
Hello, welcome back to UK Ice Hockey on 4 Later, the semi-final of the Challenge Cup. Sheffield Steelers have got a huge advantage here. They're 5-0 up. Chris, is there any way back?
I don't think there's any way back, and if there is one, I think that road is very closely guarded because I don't think Sheffield's going to let Belfast back in this game.
After the second period, you went down to the changing rooms and you saw Dave Whistle. What was the mood down there?
Well, actually, once I saw Dave Whistle, I kind of turned and walked the other way, and I saw some debris in the hallway, and I think there's been a couple of sticks that paid the price for Belfast's game here tonight, but he's a good friend, but at this point, I don't think I want to approach him because he was pacing a lot of carpet. I don't think Whistle wants to be approached at the moment.
I mean, there's nothing he can say to his players now, should he? The game's lost.
No, the only thing you can say to your players right now is just hurry up and get changed and let's get on the bus, because that's all that's left. I mean, it's time to start the bus. I think it's time to go home.
Well, a really pessimistic assessment of the Belfast Giants there from Chris McSorley, GB coach. Is there anything left for them to play for?
I think there is, but looking at Dave Whistle on the bench, he looks absolutely fed up right now. And Chris says he's been hammering a few things around the locker room. But Belfast are playing for pride. They're playing for the fact that they don't want to shut out against them. That's something in hockey that the players really hate. So they're going to be just looking to find a way past Mike O'Neill in this final period.
Well, unless something extraordinary happens, it looks like it's going to be the Sheffield Steelers facing the Ayr Scottish Eagles at the Odyssey in Belfast in the Challenge Cup final. An early goal for Belfast here might change things. Carlander wins the face-off in an attempt to get it for them. Round the back they go. Carlander picks it up again from deep. He's got Fawn Ferrone to his right, but it's stripped away from him before he can get there. And Allison on the backhand feeds it down low. And apart from anything else, Seth, all the travelling fans from Belfast deserve something from this.
They do. They've come out and they've supported their team without fail throughout this match. They've been noisy, they've been loud. The Sheffield fans have been loud as well. It's been a great atmosphere the whole game's been played in. But Belfast will really want to just take something back with them. I know they're meant to be going out after the game with the players, and they're going to want at least a couple of goals to talk about.
Well, Carlander to try and win this face-off. He does. Paul Ferrone picks it up for the Giants, fires it in, just bounces off O'Neill's knee there. Sebastian flips it forward for the Sheffield Steelers. That goes under a stick and Bowen is forced backwards to bounce that off the board. Still in the zone. Here's Norris then for the Sheffield Steelers. Puts it in low. Allison! Allison to seal it! He does! Oh, Scott Allison, what a game that man has had! Some people think he shouldn't even be out there, but he has really showed what he's made of this evening. Two goals and an assist so far.
Well, it could only be. What an inspiration he's been to the Steelers. He makes a little move around Wilkinson and there he is, just to flick it home from a couple of inches. He won't score an easier one than that this season. You know what, Colin, you better stick a fork in this one because it's done.
Sheffield Steelers giving Belfast an ice hockey lesson on their way to the Challenge Cup final. And there was still plenty of time left to make the Giants feel even smaller.
Mike Blaisdell will be a very, very happy man behind that bench. He's seen his team play absolutely wonderful hockey here this evening.
They've offered a hockey masterclass, haven't they? They've excelled in every area of the ice. And Belfast haven't been bad. Far from it. The Sheffield Steelers have just been that good this evening. And everything's gone right for them. It's just one of those days.
And they're giving it up again. Here's Norris. Oh, Norris roofs it! Allison with the feed, his fourth point of the night, coughed up by a lacklustre Belfast team in their own zone, and Norris and Allison take full advantage.
Well, the puck just breaks right off the skate of Bowen. A couple of nice moves, and then there's Warren Norris to stick it in top corner. Nearly got it stuck there. That's what we were just talking about. Everything has broken to a Steelers stick tonight. No luck at all for Belfast, and the whoosh is behind you. Go for the seventh time this evening.
Those fans, I think, can't quite believe it. They've not seen anything like this for quite some time. As good as this team has been all season, they've not delivered anything quite like this.
Scott Allison again, though, with a nice pass. But Warren Norris, great moves in tight. And he just flicks it. He does well, actually, to get it quite so high up into the corner. Wilkinson left hanging out to dry.
And poor Wilkinson, seven goals, but he's not had that bad a game.
He hasn't. He's made some crucial stops. You only shudder to think what the score would have been if he hadn't played so well.
This has gotten a little ugly right now, and I think you might see this game start turning for the worse, because I think you can see some start to see some bad blood out there, because now what's happening is this team's getting embarrassed. But let's just get right to the fact. Belfast is a great hockey club. They're just not having a good evening. And again, I discussed earlier, Sheffield's had the night of their life, and I just think you can see things continue.
Well, bad blood is exactly what happened. Couple of big hits, and then Warren Norris scored the last Sheffield goal, taking a stick in the mouth from Todd Goodwin. It led to the most amazing scenes. With just 3 minutes left on the clock, Norris, furious over the incident with Goodwin, then enraged the Belfast bench by pointing to the 7-0 scoreline on the arena scoreboard, led to his own coach, Mike Blaisdell, stepping in to haul him off the ice. A strange end to the evening for Norris. And he was forced to sit out the rest of a match that was going pretty well for him up to that point, with one goal and one assist. But still, it wasn't quite over.
Behind Dave Whistle, you can see the Steelers fans rising to their feet. They're acclaiming their team. It's put on an extraordinary show as we approach the final minute of this game. But Seth, that Warren Norris incident just indicating some tension and frustration.
Yeah, I think he just got a little bit fed up. He doesn't like to get sticked in the face, but then who does? But Mike Blaisdell just telling him to just shut up. We've won the game and show a little bit of class. That's what the suggestion was from the bench.
Schulte trying to feed it out in front. Carlander was trying to intercept it. Rick Brabant can clear it away for the Sheffield Steelers, and all the way back now will go Shane Johnson to try and set it up again for the Belfast Giants. Still desperate to get past Mike O'Neill. Johnson out towards this right-hand side now. Carlander brings it in. He's got Schulte behind him. Carlander flips it into that corner. O'Neill watches it calmly go past. Brabant misses out on the hit there. He just dived out of the way of that hit and then into the corner. And all sorts of tussling going on in there. Sebastian's involved. Ferrone's involved. Schulte is in there. They're all involved at the moment. And this is not the way we want to see this great game break down.
Well, it's just frustration from the Belfast Giants. Paul Ferrone, really, really proud man. And him and Rick Brabant.
We have one clean fight breaking out behind the play. Ferrone and Brabant just exchanging punches. Ferrone's helmet comes off. He's definitely getting the best of this one. Firing right in the head of Brabant, who's trying to put a couple over the top. Now Matt Folker, the linesman, is going to try and separate those two. Paul Ferrone got some shots off, and Belfast have won one thing tonight.
Yeah, Paul Ferrone, one of Belfast's tough guys, along with Paxton Schulte. Rick Brabant, well, he's more of a skilled player, and I think there was only ever going to be one winner there. Let's have a look at the replay. Rick Brabant looked like he was going to get run. He got the puck here, and that's Ferrone. Oh, I think he's got a little bit of knee-on-knee contact as well as he came in. Adam Smith then came across, so did Jeff Sebastian. Everybody got involved, and then eventually at the back of that group, Rick Brabant aired his frustration.
Well, Paul Ferrone is going to take a walk, but that was Steelers players there trying to protect a skilled player from what would have been a nasty hit.
Oh, definitely, and that's one of the unwritten rules in ice hockey. If you're a tough guy, you don't mess with the skilled players.
Well, the game is just about over. Belfast took their frustrations out, or tried to, on Rick Brabant, who took a little bit of a beating in the subsequent fight from Paul Ferrone, who's off the ice now. None of it is going to matter in the long run to the Sheffield Steelers coach Mike Blaisdell or their fans, because they are on their way to Belfast for the Challenge Cup final. Still, though, the Giants will look to break the shutout. They flip it forward now on Mike O'Neill. That'll bounce all the way past him. McCosh will pick it up for the Sheffield Steelers, wearing the captain's C in the absence of Dennis Vial. On his own line now, he's happy just to see this clock count down on what has been a great, great performance from this Sheffield Steelers side. Down the left-hand side they know now. Allison feeding it to Weaver. Allison's driven this game. Weaver flipping it out in front, turned away by Wilkinson. Picked up by Short, even he's jumping into the play now. Turns it around from the corner under pressure. Robs driven in. Wilkinson sends that rebound out long, and it's cleared away by the Belfast Giants. And the arms in the air, the ticker tape goes up, and the Sheffield Steelers fans now fight for their tickets to the Odyssey Arena.
Scott Allison looked to get the hat-trick with a long shot right at the end of the game there. But two goals and two assists coming back off that suspension. He's just been an inspiration to the Sheffield Steelers this evening. The Giants, though, they lost the game, but they certainly weren't disgraced. They were just beaten by a team who had their night this evening and played out of their skin.
A shutout for O'Neill, and the Grand Slam still on for the Sheffield Steelers.
So an absolutely stunning victory for the Steelers. Belfast just never standing a chance against a team at the very top of their game.
We thought it would be much tougher, but we prepared quite well, I thought. We had some good rest for some of our key players, and there was something on the line tonight. We weren't very sharp the last few games, but we came to play tonight and showed our true colours tonight, I think.
How important was Scott Allison to that performance?
Well, I think he just gave us a lift, you know, and I started on the first shift of the game, just because I knew our crowd would be behind him. And then it was a dream start because he scores the goal, and that just got the crowd going. And then it was an avalanche after that, I think.
To be honest, the guys have been going through a lot of games, and I had 10 days rest, and I had a few days out here on the ice by myself, and it kind of reminded me when I was a kid back in Canada, you know, just yourself, and the lights were down low, and I was shooting pucks, and it just made me remember what it's like to put a pair of skates on and just go out to play hockey for the joy of it, because it is a beautiful game, and it's like football, and everybody feels the way around England about football the way I feel about ice hockey, and just to go out and just to work hard, and I'm just a happy guy right now to help my team get to the final.
I mean, it looked like men versus boys out there tonight, right from the start to the finish. Our game plan was not to let them score in the first 5 minutes of the game, control them a little bit. We're losing 2-0, 1-0 in the first 40 seconds, so it didn't go to our game plan for sure. But once it went 3-4, I think the heads went down, and they're such a hard team to come back on. You know, that's why I didn't want any goals in the first 5 minutes. We want to take away the crowd. The crowd was awesome here tonight. They were loud for their team, cheering all the time. And that makes a big difference. And right from start to finish, Sheffield outplayed us, and they showed why they're first.
We would have been tough to beat by for any team in the league tonight. And Belfast found out that when we're on our game, that we're a tough nut to crack.
The trick now is to capture that feeling for the final against Ayr, isn't it?
Well, the actual feeling should take care of itself. We're excited about it. You know, I mean, we won the league early enough to kind of relax and come down off that win, and that's what paid off. I think if we'd have won the league like 2 days ago, we'd have never won tonight like we did.
Well, it was a very one-sided contest in the end, Chris. Now I look forward to the final between Ayr and Sheffield. Can Ayr really overturn Sheffield?
I don't know. I mean, I just know one thing, that this is one team with Sheffield that I don't think is going to be able to be beaten. Ayr's got a great, dangerous team, and DeRuelville, their goaltender, is going to have the game of his life. Because this Sheffield attack, I don't see what's going to stop it. Because all I know is how the Sheffield offense, you know, I coach and preach and show video, because they're so skilled, so deep. They got 9 forwards that can take the puck to the net. And how do you coach against a team that really doesn't have any chinks in their armor?
Well, Chris, thank you very much for joining us tonight. Join us next week. We'll be covering the final between Ayr Scottish Eagles and the Sheffield Steelers in Belfast. It's already a sellout. And you know what those Belfast fans are like? 7,000 people screaming their heads off. It should be a great atmosphere and it should well be a great match.